Hi guys, welcome back. Today I will share with you my process in making a 10 heads fashion figure. This is going to be an easy step-by-step instructional video so you can follow along. First, these are the materials I use. Faber-Castell Pencil H, Koh-i-noor Pencil Eraser, and Uni Pin Drawing Pen. And oh, I also use a grid ruler for this one. First thing we need to do is create a guide for us to be able to easily locate the parts of the figure. Here, I drew 11 horizontal lines 1 inch apart. We will call these spaces in between the lines heads. The first head being head number 1, and the next one number 2, and so on. Oh, before I forget, don't forget to add a long vertical line at the center of your paper. This will allow you to understand the center of your figure. We will also label the lines so we don't get confused during the process. So, there, from line 1 up top, going to line number 11 at the very bottom. So, why are we doing this, you might ask? Well, each head is 1 inch tall, so basically, it's called 10 heads because the whole height of our figure is the exact height of what 10 equal heads on top of each other is. So, if one head is 1 inch tall, this figure will be 10 inches tall once done. Alright, let's start with the first head. I will draw an egg shape and I will make sure I use all 1 inch space. There! Nice! Now, ready your rulers because we will need it now. Let's now locate where your shoulders are going to be. We will put our shoulder line in between line 2 and line 3. So, we will divide head number 2 in half. There you go. Let's label this shoulder. Now, for the shoulder width, we don't want it too narrow or too broad. So, we are just going to do 1.5 inch. But, make sure that you know where the center is so that your shoulders are going to be the same on each part. There you go! Now we will create an inverted triangle. From the tip of your shoulder line, we will add lines going down to the center of line number 4. And that is your inverted triangle. Next, we will connect the head to the shoulder. We will draw the neck. The neck will be slightly thinner than your head. The next part of the body we will do is the hips. The hip line will fall 1/4 inch below line number 5. First, locate line number 5 and go to the center line. From there, go down for 1/4 inch and mark it. That's your hip line. Now, for the width of your hip, we are gonna do the same width as your shoulders. So it's also going to be 1.5 inches. And from there, we create another triangle and connect it to the first triangle we did, creating an hourglass figure. Okay, nice. Now, let me just clean this up a little bit. Now that we are done with the torso, it's time to locate the knees. Now, the knee is going to be in between line number 7 and line number 8. So what we're going to do is we are going to divide head number 7 in half. There. Let's label that knee. Okay, so let's continue. Now, parallel to the hips, I am going to create 2 circles that will represent the kneecaps. This is going to also serve as the joints for your knees. And after the knees, of course, we're going to do the ankles as well. The ankles are going to be right at the 10th line, or line number 10. Okay, good. Let's label that ankles. Now, what are we missing? Well, she doesn't have arms yet. But first, let me add 2 circles right inside the shoulder tips right here. This will serve as my shoulder caps. Doing the arms is just like doing the legs. First, locate the elbow. The elbow is at the same line as your waist. And that is line number 4, okay? While the wrist is at the same line as the hips. Your hip line, well, that's 1/4 inch below line number 5. After all of that, let's now work on completing the female figure. And let's start with the neck. Let's connect the neck to the shoulder caps by blending a curve from halfway of the neck and connecting it to the circles I added on the shoulders earlier. And nice! Okay, that's good. Let me clean up a little bit. And of course, the next thing that we are going to do is connect the shoulders to the elbows. Now, the waist. Now, we don't want the waist to be too big and too small. So for this project, I think let's settle for 3/4 inch. Well, there you go. Not too big and not too small. And from here, what we're going to do is we are going to connect the ends of the waistline to the shoulders. Okay, good. Now, let's connect the waist to the hips. The female hip curves outward. So, we will connect the waist to the hips with a convex, making sure that the biggest part is still the hips. Cool! I like the way it looks, so now let's clean up. So, let's just fast forward a little bit because this video is getting too long now. Let's connect the arms. Don't forget to give your arm slight curves to suggest muscles. Looking good! Now, just to give it a little bit of definition, let's add the female breast. Now, I'm putting the bottom part of the breast right at 3/8 of an inch of head number 3. Now, let's connect the legs. But first, what I always do with my illustrations is I always add a thigh gap. So, from the crotch area center line, I'm going to add about 1/8 or 1/4 of a gap between each thigh. And from there, I connect it to the knees. And from the knees, I connect it to the ankles. Okay, but I made a little bit of a mistake here because I think the ankles are too close to the center or to each other. So I'm going to spread it a little bit, making the legs look like it's spread. Now, I am not going to be very detailed when it comes to muscles in this video, but understanding the human anatomy really helps when it comes to definitions like this. To finish it up, don't forget to add basic feet and hands. For the feet, it's going to be wearing high heels, so it's going to use the whole 1 inch of space number 10. And oh, you may also add face. I made a separate video about the face, and I will leave a link at the description box. Don't forget to check it too. There you go! Your complete 10 heads female figure for a fashion illustration. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to check my other videos to learn more about my illustration techniques. And also, don't forget to subscribe so you get notified every time I upload new videos. Thank you guys! See you again soon!